Hi guys! So today's video is actually an ombre eyeliner, and it is this look that I'm wearing right now. It was a little bit of a struggle. I actually did it with a dual lip liner from NYX, and I think it turned out pretty good. If you guys like this look, just go ahead and keep on. So the first thing I'm going to use for this look is this NYX liquid felt tip, what's it called? Colored felt tip liner. And so I'm going to be using this in white to help vibrant the next thing that I'm going to be using, which is this NYX Ombre Lip Duo. Now obviously by the name, this is actually four lips, but oh well. So what I'm going to start to do is I'm just going to do a general winged liner, but with the white. I'm sorry if I get out of frame. I haven't played with this white quite too much, so it's kind of going to take some getting used to, I think. A lot. The tip of it is like seriously so long, like you gotta really know what you're doing, because eventually the end gets dried up and you gotta like push for it. You know what I mean? It's felt tip liner, I guess it's general information. So first impressions, since this is kind of the first time I've actually use this as an eyeliner, it's not the most comforting thing to be putting on your eye. Like it's kind of rough, I guess I'll say that. Alright, and what I'm gonna keep doing is just kind of basically just drying it and dipping it in the excess that comes out. I wish they had this in like a liquid liner. I definitely would have got that, but when I was at the store I didn't see anything like that. This was the only thing that they had there that was white, so I got it. Alright, so it's not perfect, but and then look, it's got kinda dirty from my eyeshadow, but not too bad. And then next I'm gonna go in with this boy. I'm gonna do the red on the outside and then the yellow on the inside. And I kinda wanna start with the outside just cause that's usually how I do my eyeliner. So we're gonna go ahead and try that. And if you're wondering why obviously I'm looking down here, it's cause I have a mirror. Oh my god. Okay, and do you see this? Do you see how flat that is? That is because of my boyfriend. He told me the story and I knew exactly what happened, and this is the first time I've looked at it since. So the story behind this, I already know. He freaking rolled it up like this and was like, oh, what the heck is that? And then just shoved the cap on it, and that's why it's flat now, because it was pointed. I promise you, it was pointed. So now I get to try and use it flat because of him. He sucks. And the yellow one, it's a lot thicker, like it's a lot bigger, because it's supposed to be used as like the main fill-in for your lips, but it's pointy. So, still gonna have a struggle with that. Obviously, this is not meant for your eyes, but we're gonna try it anyways. Here goes nothing. I feel like I really should have tape. But I don't think I have any. I should really find some though. Do I have tape? I don't think I do. Oh well. Oh! Look! It flaked out on me. Ooh, okay. It rolls. Oh, it's broken off already. That's why. Back in. god. It just broke. Okay. So far, this is not going well. Maybe... And I'm just doing short little strokes right now. Before I epically ruin it, like what the hell? What the hell kind of wing is that? Oh god. And I got red on my face. It's going great. And then for where we're gonna have them to meet, I'm just gonna very ratchetly go over that. Great. Good thing I didn't actually pay for this. This was in my BeautyCon box, if you watch the video. Oh, you just... God, this is a piece of crap. It just... I haven't even used it once yet. It's already, like, broken. All over. That's not really great. So look at that. Look at that end. You're not gonna be able to see that. But the end isn't like not happy. It's not great. Don't buy it. I'm just kidding. Maybe I just got that one. I don't know. But let's try this fat part with to get this skinniness. I'm gonna try and go back in with the red and just fix up a couple areas, and then I'm gonna go and like kind of tight line my eyeliner with some concealer, because what is that? I don't know what that is. It's not good. One brush that I use to, I'm gonna keep saying tight line, I don't know why I wanna say that, but the one brush that I use is a Sigma, why can't I talk? The one brush that I use is a small angle Sigma E65 brush. It's very small, pretty dense, but it's very soft, especially if you're going to be using it like I am around your eyes. It's very good. Usually I have been using it for my eyebrows. And then for the concealer today, if you watched like my second video ever, you know how I feel about these. I used them today. It's the biggest mistake of my life. So hopefully when I try and use this concealer, it's not just gonna move the foundation, because I found that that's what happens with this infallible foundation. And all I'm gonna do is just lift it up a little bit, and I'm just gonna kind of dip it onto that stick just to get enough. And I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me in Fair Claire. This is extra light and it's a pink toned, as opposed to what I usually use, which is number 20, and it's sand. You can see the difference. Pink one, tan one. I'm gonna use the pink one. Alright, I think I turned it pink. Do you see? It just turned my concealer pink. So I'm just gonna dab that with my finger, try and get off the excess. It looks better. I'm gonna clean off my brush. I'm just using one of these magic eraser makeup wipes. If you rub your brush on them, that's all just from rubbing a brush. It cleans your brushes pretty well. Not like cleans them, but spot cleans them, I guess, pretty much. Pretty well. So now we're gonna try and work with this monstrosity right here. Disgusting. I hate it. Okay, you can see it turned it pink. In real life, the pink underneath it isn't really that noticeable, so I think all I'm gonna do is take some loose powder and the same brush, and oh my god, that's way too much. Just dip it in there and kind of just try and set it so that it's not gonna, that red's not gonna bleed. I'm going to be using this smudger brush of these, this Eco Tool set that I got. And it has purple all over it from the last thing that I did, so I'm gonna try and clean it off. Again, just rub-a-dub-dub, man. It works. Hopefully this works. I guess it doesn't look terrible. Let me just brush off and then just to help it out a bit more, I'm just going to be taking this fluffy angled brush right here, and I'm going to take from my shaded light palette, I'm going to take a little bit of that banana and just that light, just a little bit of this, and mix it with a little bit of this, and just dab it under there, and then kind of drag, just kind of mix it in with the under of my eyes, because that is what I put on to set my under eye, because I have that horrible, horrible foundation on my face. It was literally so bad. Like, I put it on, just squirted it out of the tube, put some on my finger, started dabbing it in place on my face, and then was gonna use a brush to blend it in, and looked terrible. So I was like, alright, I guess I'll go wet my beauty blender and use that, and that looked even worse, so still don't like it. Don't think I'll ever try it again. Probably the only other way I might try it is if I end up doing a makeup video where I do my boyfriend's makeup, but I think as of right now, it's probably about the only place you're gonna see me use that. The last step is to go ahead and put on your choice of mascara, and that will complete this look. One eye. Looks pretty good, right? Looks pretty good, even though it was a struggle. That's the worst one. There's hair on it. Oh, it was a big one. Just for case in point, just so you guys can see the difference that just a simple coat of mascara makes. A world. Alright guys, so this is the finished look. If you guys liked it, go ahead and comment and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what video I should do next, what you guys want to see. If you want to maybe see me try this with a different color, a different product, let me know. I'm all up for suggestions, and I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Bye!